Hey guys, it's Dagan from PMTV UK, and today I'm here to show you 7 cheap acoustic guitars that don't suck. Cheap acoustic guitars have a bit of a bad rep these days, and I reckon that's solely because back in the day, 30, 40 years ago, if you wanted to start playing guitar, all you could really afford was a cheap acoustic made of balsa wood with the action about that high. But times have changed a lot since then. All pound coins now have a bit of silver in the middle of it, and all paper money's plastic. But acoustic guitars have came along leaps and bounds. I hear it time and time again on a daily basis working in a PMT store. Oh, I wish I had this back in the day when I was learning how to play guitar. I wish I had this, I wish I had that. These days, they're that good. They're made to play well, be affordable, and look the part. Because that's one of the reasons everyone seems to play guitar, isn't it? Because you want to look cool. And if something looks good, it'll make you pick it up more. So without further ado, I'm here today to talk to you about 7 of what I believe to be of the best cheap acoustic guitars that certainly don't suck. Some of them have preamps in, some of them don't. So to keep it all equal, we're recording it all through this lovely Aston Origin microphone. We have offerings from Tanglewood, Washburn, Fender, and East Coast. Let's get started with this guy. This is the fabulous Washburn WLD-10S. And it sounds great, but it looks the business too. Washburn is an astounding company. They've been going for many, many years, making both acoustic and electric guitars of every price point. And there's a reason they haven't stopped or went bankrupt. They're all absolutely great. It plays fantastic and looks amazing. It's a WLD, so that stands for Dreadnought. They also make a WLO, which is an orchestra size. It's got a solid cedar spruce top, laminated rosewood back and sides, lovely cathedral pitch advanced X bracing inside, which is also solid spruce. Lovely rosewood board, satin mahogany neck with a dual action truss rod. Rosewood bridge, it comes with clear tone strings, which is fabulous. It's got a Graftech new bone nut, 25.5-inch scale, 1¾ nut width. The Woodline series don't feature a preamp, unfortunately, but it sounds great mic'd up, as you can hear. Perfect dreadnought as well. It hasn't got a daft cutaway here. It's got 20 frets, so it stops at the 14th. It's a very resonant bit of kit, and solid top certainly helps with that. You can really tell when something's a solid top, and Washburn have let you have one for a lovely, lovely price. It's great for pick style, like I've been playing as of yet. Or finger style. So there we have it. Those are some specs and sounds on the lovely Washburn WLD-10S. Like I say, no preamp, so we're coming through a microphone, but if you want to hear it with your real ears, pop into a PMT store and try one out for your fine self. This is the Tanglewood TWCR-O. The O stands for orchestra, which is this lovely shape. It's got a slightly skinnier waist than the usual dreadnought, which this also comes in, a TWCRD. Check out the PMTV YouTube channel for Sam's video on that, coming very, very shortly. Back to this guy. This is not an expensive guitar. I think at the minute it's under £100, but the pound does change and do what it wants these days. So for under 100 quid, this is a remarkable thing. Off the bat, what you're probably thinking is, these suck. I tuned this up like 15 minutes ago, have not touched it since. It's not in tune anymore, but no, it's totally in tune. It's so fun to play. This has not been set up since it's arrived at PMT from Tanglewood. It's in a lovely shade too. This is called Whiskey Barrel Burst, and it does look like a whiskey barrel. The whole thing is satin. It's mahogany back and sides. It's got a teak wood neck, 25 and a half inch scale, a 43 mil nut. Yeah, it's an absolute rock machine. Stops at the 14th fret. So yeah, an octave worth of stuff, but anyone who plays up like this on an acoustic guitar, you bloody show off just because I can't do it, but. Tanglewood is obviously a British company, so I enjoy seeing these on the walls of our lovely PMT stores. For the price, man, I don't know what to say about this guy. It sounds good, it plays good. It hasn't got electronics in it. I do believe you can get them with electronics. So if it's not coming through for you nicely through this lovely Ashton Origin, come to a PMT store and try one off for yourself, either this one or one of the other shapes. Good for fingerstyle too. The mahogany neck isn't too big, it isn't too slim, it's just like Rapunzel's porridge. Is it Rapunzel who has a porridge with the three bears? No. Let me know how wrong I am in the comments down below. It could be Rapunzel, might not be though. I've realised what Goldilocks are now. So there we are, ladies and gents. The Tanglewood TWCRO orchestra also comes in a dreadnought shape. This certainly doesn't suck for a cheap acoustic guitar. This is the East Coast SA20D in Natural. This is the cheapest acoustic guitar I could find in PMT, and it certainly doesn't suck. It's not a lot of money at all, but one, it looks the business, two, it plays great straight from the factory, and three, it sounds good, which probably should have been number one. It's got a basswood top, basswood back and sides, a stained maple neck and bridge, so it's not actually rosewood, a NATO neck, which is pretty much just mahogany, and it's a dreadnought size. It sounds fantastic. The tuners stay in tune fantastic. It hasn't got a strap button here, but it means you can get your Johnny Cash or Elvis Presley on with this lovely dashing white strap if you have one yourself. It doesn't come with electronics, but you can get similar East Coast guitars for a similar price that do. And I've got to say, the dreadnought thing really works with guitar. I believe it's the first basswood topped guitar I've played, and it resonates very, very nicely. So those were some specs and sounds on the East Coast SA20D in Natural. I say natural because it does come in a variety of lovely, lovely colours. This is the Fender Malibu player guitar. And doesn't she look great? In my humble opinion, this is one of the best looking acoustic guitars Fender brought out in an awfully long time, but I do like very daft garish things. It does look great, doesn't it? It's slightly shorter, almost a folk guitar, if you will. It's got a Malibu body shape, which is awfully folky. It's 24.1 inch scale. This finish is candy apple red. It does come in a few lovely finishes, just as lovely and garish as this one. Lovely gold appointments. It's a three ply gold and white pickguard. Solid spruce top, mahogany back and sides. This one has a Fishman preamp in it as well, with the treble, bass, volume control, and a built-in tuner. But for the sake of this video, which is seven cheap acoustic guitars that don't suck, I'm using this lovely Aston Origin microphone. Mahogany neck, a walnut fingerboard, a Graphtech Newbone 43mm nut, a Strat headstock, which is painted the same color as the body. Fender, stop it! Stop it, Fender! Sorry, it just gets my juices going when I see matching headstocks, especially when it's a Strat shape. But this color, man. Ah, so good. Great, sorry, there's a little silica pack inside rattling about, because this is brand new out the box. I took it out of the box about 10 minutes ago. Give it a little bit of a tune. It's set up amazing. This is the kind of guitar you just want to get a little case for, chuck it in the back of your car when you go to the beach, and just sit and jam out on it and watch all the guys and gals come at you like that, because your guitar is really pretty and it's super easy to play because it's a shorter scale. With it being a smaller guitar, it's kind of got a lovely, not nasal quality, but quite high quality. It's nice and brash, especially when you use it with a pick. This will cut through anything, whether it be mic'd up or plugged in. Sing along with me, YouTube. So yeah, this seems like an appropriate guitar to play Faith on. That was the Alan Biscuit version, definitely not the George Michael version. But yeah, stunning guitar, comes in a variety of beautiful colors. Definitely doesn't suck for the price. It's got a matching headstock and it's candy apple red and gold. Come check it out. This guy is the Epiphone Pro 1 in natural. Epiphone have done it again with another extremely affordable guitar that looks the part, plays the part, and certainly doesn't suck. It's got a spruce top and select mahogany back and sides that are slightly thinner than your standard dreadnought. It's got proprietary, get it? Epiphone Pro, proprietary, bracing inside of it. It's got a mahogany neck with jumbo Pro frets, a rosewood board with Pro Ease lubricant, a Graphtech nut, which is 43mm. The whole guitar is 24¾-inch scale. It's got a lovely slanted back headstock with that classic Epiphone logo, which is a metal. It's a lovely touch. Epiphone always managed to make things look that nice and rustic and 60s and where everything started for them. But this guitar plays fantastic, looks fantastic, and is lovely and cheap. A couple of cool little appointments on this guitar is the neck profile is what they call an EZ C shape. Super easy neck to play. What you do find when people start playing guitar is they're drawn more towards electric guitar, simply because they're a little bit easier to play. But if you want to enjoy acoustic guitar, this neck feels like an electric neck. It's a beautiful neck. It's not too big, not too small, good to get your hand around. But my favorite thing about this, it's got a scratchless pickguard. Epiphone call this a scratchless pickguard. And I'm sure it's covered by our warranty, but don't take a Stanley knife to it or try and scratch it. It's good though. It's an extremely resonant guitar, whether you're strumming, picking, or playing fingerstyle, it's lovely. Yes, Epiphone. So that was the Epiphone Pro 1 acoustic guitar. Some specs and some sounds, showing you how good it looks. Look at that headstock, man. Look at that headstock. Beautiful thing, that's worth 100 quid right there. This is the Yamaha APX 500-3. One of my favorite guitars in the world. The reason I love the APX 500s are because I think they were coined towards me. A guitarist that learned on electric guitar and picked up his first acoustic guitar and thought, on that, this is big, this is scary, I can't get away with this, I'm just gonna keep playing electric for a while. These guys are lovely and thin, they've got a beautiful neck, they're super easy to play, they're not very expensive, and they sound the business. They've got a spruce top, they've either got a NATO or a Coombe back and sides. One of the main things about the APXs though is their signature oval sound hole, which kind of helps boost low end because smaller body guitars can be a little bit tinny, but this certainly isn't. We are making it up for the series that we're doing right now, which is the 7 cheapest acoustic guitars that don't suck, but it has got the System 66 Yamaha preamp in it, which has a volume, a 3-band EQ, and an active mid-frequency slider, and a lovely tuner. Neck-wise, it's a lovely neck, it's more electric-based, so like I said, it's why I love them to absolute bits. Rosewood fretboard, it's got a cutaway so you can get to the higher bits and shred, which I can't. It's a gloss body with a satin NATO neck. The black's probably my favorite color, but it is a bit tricky to keep clean. It does come in natural, red, blue, lots of other colors. Check out the PMT website for those details. 22 of Yamaha's finest frets, a urea nut and bridge, I think, which isn't what I think it is. So let's hear it some more. These are so comfy, I could play it all night. So it's a perfect axe for every conceivable genre of acoustic music. I'm guessing it sounds pretty good plugged into a Boss DS1 through a Marshall stack as well, because it's super electric feeling. 25.5-inch scale, 43mm nut. It's a rock machine. This is the Fender CD60 SCE, all mahogany. And when Fender say all mahogany, they mean all mahogany. It's mahogany top, mahogany back, mahogany sides, mahogany neck, mahogany shoes, mahogany raincoat. It's a beautiful, beautiful bit of guitar. Like I said, this is the SCE, it also comes in a CD60S. The CE stands for cutaway and electro. So the standard S is obviously a normal dreadnought size guitar with no electronics in. I thought I'd spruce it up a little bit and use this guy because I personally enjoy a cutaway. For the sake of this video though, I'm micing it up with an Aston Origin microphone as opposed to using the Fishman CD preamp, which has one volume, treble and bass control, and a tuner. With it being all mahogany, it's got a lovely richness to it. Whether you're playing back here when it's bright, or at the front when it's soft. Well, that sounds nice, doesn't it? Oh, it's good. The neck on this is what Fender call an easy to play neck, which is very easy to play. Thank you, Fender, great marketing there. It's got rolled fretboard edges as well, just like the 5 grand custom shop things, but this is nowhere near £5,000. What helps with the resonance as well is the fact that it's got scalloped X bracing inside, and it's 25.3 inches in scale length. That's a weird way of saying that. 25.3 inch scale. 43 mil nuts, so very standard, but it doesn't sound standard. It sounds lovely. Where's the chord? There it is. If you enjoyed how badly I played that there, please comment down below and tear me to shreds. But don't tear this guitar to shreds, because it sounds phenomenal. I think mahogany guitars may be my new favorite, thanks to this guy. I've always been a big, very spruce top kind of guy, because it cuts through a bit more, but this is lovely. It's so rich and nice. Sorry, I need to stop just playing a G chord, but if you don't believe me, come into your nearest PMT store and play a G chord on this bad boy. So that was the Fender CD60 SCE. All mahogany, a guitar so good, it made me sing. So there we have it, guys. That is a wrap. That is what I believe to be 7 of the best cheap acoustic guitars that certainly don't suck. What was your favorite? I thought my favorite was the APX until I played this guy. This is lovely. I'm gonna play that G chord again. Hey!
There we go, right there.
Right in the kisser. If you enjoyed this daftness with all these lovely guitars, give this video a like and subscribe to PMTV UK on YouTube for loads of cool more guitar and music related content. What was your favorite? Let me know down below. And tell me how wrong I am if I shouldn't be enjoying this so much. If you want any more info on any of the guitars I spoke about tonight, go to pmtonline.co.uk or call into one of your forever expanding beautiful PMT stores. Each one of our lovely stores has its own Twitter, Instagram and Facebook page. Be sure to like your local one or them all if you're feeling that nice. I've been Dagan, and I film these videos after the shop closes, and I reckon I can sneak this out into my car. I'll see you later.